This morning in the kitchen, Chef Alberto is here from the Dorrance. We've got a great fish dish on the menu today. We are making striped bass,
yes,
right?
Good morning, hi.
How are we going to be cooking the fish?
It's going to be pan roasted, and I'm going to serve it with a bamboo rice.
Okay, tell us about this bamboo rice, because the color alone is intriguing. How does it get that way?
It's the chlorophyll from young bamboo plants when they grow in the bamboo. Is the rice. It's a short grain rice. So you treat it almost like sushi, but it becomes nice and tight, and it tastes, is, I like to describe it, like jasmine and green tea.
But very faint, though,
very
right?
Faint.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
that's good to
it's
know.
A nice
you said it's
floral.
It's similar to sushi, so does it have that sticky texture?
A little bit.
A little bit.
Not as much.
Okay. Now, in addition to the bass and the rice, what else do we need?
Well, we have fiddleheads, which are coming out in season early spring.
And these are these fun little curlicues right here, right?
Yep, the ferns. And I like to describe it, they taste like asparagus and okra at the same time.
Yum. It's a good combination.
Mm-hmm. And these beautiful petite carrots that are also coming out in season, mm-hmm. and some French radishes.
Great. And then a little, what, little salt, little pepper?
Little salt, pepper.
Couple
little love
herbs
that we're going to give to the fish later on.
A little love.
Little
we
love.
Like that. You were saying that this is a great time of year for you because you're mixing things up. A lot more produce is coming your
mm-hmm.
way, right?
The local farmers that we deal with, they send me emails and calling me and say, Chef, this is available, this is coming out. So to me, I start to do research, and we just get the gears going for new menus. So.
Yeah, a lot of fun and a lot more excitement too happening over at the Dorrance, which we will get to coming up a little later on in the show. Big event, you don't want to miss it.
We want to send it back into the kitchen where Will awaits with Chef Alberto from the Dorrance.
That's right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Dorrance is the restaurant. We are ready to start cooking. We got local striped bass on the menu. We're ready to go.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to pan roast the salmon.
Okay. And you had this pan pretty hot before.
Pretty hot. It gives a nice sear, nice caramelization on the
right.
Fish.
Okay.
Turn up the heat a little bit.
Turn that up. That's a good size piece right there,
yeah.
too.
Nice size.
And you also nice put portion. Skin side down, correct?
Skin side down. I'm gonna flip it over to display the skin when we cook it. Got the carrots going, and this I have a nice red pepper sauce, nice velvety consistency, which is gonna be that.
So just crackle away for a little bit. Now the carrots themselves. Do you want them still to have a little bite back to them? You don't want them to sit in there too long.
No, little al dente. Okay. So it has a nice little bite to it. And you can see a nice color on the skin.
Okay.
I'm gonna give it the nice caramelization on the other side. And with this peppers, just add a little cream, just reduce everything.
Just red peppers, you kind of chopped them up?
Chopped them up, let the nice flavors of the red peppers come out, the
right.
color. And then once it cooks, we're gonna puree it, and it's gonna be nice, this velvety consistency here.
Nice. Well, you know, I mean, it's even something just like this, even if it's not just for seafood, you can put that on any.
You can put it with fish, you can
right.
put it with scallops, mainly chicken, you know, you can,
right,
you
yeah.
can do it with chicken as well, but
okay.
I think fish is a nice combination, nice sweetness to
and,
the fish.
And as far as the fish itself here that you have going, a lot of people, obviously, because today's only Thursday, tomorrow, good Friday,
mm-hmm.
they're looking for something different to cook. After we have this on here, are we placing this in the oven, or everything's going to be finished right here?
It's a nice thick piece, so to cook all the way through, just put in the oven, pop in the oven for about 350.
Okay.
Probably about 15 minutes.
And how are you going to know when this is done? People, like at a certain, you don't want to obviously overcook this either.
Well, there's a couple of tricks. The trick is you grab a pie.
Yeah.
To check the pies
right.
or cakes.
Oh, yeah. Well,
and just, you know, poke
put
it.
Put it in and see if it has
a little bit of resistance.
Then you're good to go.
Cook.
Yeah,
but if it goes nice and soft,
right. then you are good
all
to
the way
go.
Through.
All right,
so.
Sounds good. We will put this in the oven just a little bit. We're going to talk about everything that's going on at the Dorrance because they are always busy. Back to you. If you are at home wondering what to make for dinner tonight on this Holy Thursday, Chef Alberto Lopez from the Dorrance, he has got you covered. We got a lot of stuff going on. What do we need to do right now?
So the fish is done.
Mm-hmm.
This is the final product and the pepper sauce that I made.
Oh, so that really thickened up a lot too, as well, right?
Mm-hmm. Nice yeah. and reduced, and it isn't strained.
Okay.
Very through a fine strainer,
yep.
so you get all the skin out of the peppers.
Now,
good.
Can you use that sauce on other meats and things? I know you're pairing it with the fish
with
today.
Fish goes very well. You can also do it with chicken.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, very nice subtle flavor.
Right.
So it's very useful.
And just so everybody knows, you had some red peppers in there. You cubed them up, kind of let them simmer for just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
A little cream in there as well, right?
A little cream. Mm-hmm.
Cream as well, and then pureed it, and that's what you get.
Exactly.
Good.
Yum.
All right.
Looks good.
Okay. What do you want to do right now?
So this is the other ingredient that I brought in. This is the.
What is that?
This is bamboo rice. This
All
is
right.
This is a short grain rice that when they grow in the rice, they puree.
Looks like candy.
Yeah. Nice Easter color.
Yeah.
So, and you said it tastes kind of like a jasmine tea or a green tea.
Exactly.
So very, very refreshing. And
very
green
refreshing.
Tea, we know, is very good for you.
Yeah, yeah. And it's also high in vitamin B.
Okay.
It's really good for you.
All right.
Okay. These are also local fiddleheads that are, spring is coming, so there's a lot of cool ingredients coming out in spring. So
yeah, which you're incorporating into your menu, right? New spring menu over at
the
Dorrance?
New spring menu at the Dorrance, new spring drink menu as well.
Okay.
You know, Vito is a genius, so I have to keep up with Vito. So.
Sure.
Yeah, so two new menus. And you were saying that you actually, well, we caught wind that you had a funny menu.
Oh, it was.
Yesterday. Tell us about that.
They had me in tears when I was reading it.
No, this was the food menu or the drink menu?
This is the drink menu.
The drink menu.
This is the second time that he comes with his drink menu. The first menu, from what I hear, went viral. So.
Oh, all right.
You know, so he comes up with... you know, some really fun names for the menus, and you know, it's
what were some of the obscure ones that you just thought, oh, this can't be real?
One was when you're waiting for your Tinder date.
Yeah,
you drink this and you drink that, and you know, it was just
hilarious. Just having a little fun
just
with
having
it.
A little fun.
And that's
Good.
What you can expect over at the Dorrance too. A lot of fun, whether you're enjoying a great drink or a nice meal like this. So I think we can start plating
can
it up.
Plate this up and show us what it looks like.
So this is what it's going to look like.
Okay. That's a cool plate, too.
It almost looks like a cutting board.
It's great.
You know, people see with their, you know, with their eyes first.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So, excuse me.
You make a very good point, Chef, because it's, you know, if it looks so appealing, it makes you want to eat it even more. Wow.
Look at you. Nice.
See, this is one that you're going to want to take
That's
a photo
cool.
of and
That's
throw
really
it up
cool
on, like, Instagram
that.
Or
so
Twitter or
Facebook.
So it's all
about presentation. Excuse me again.
Very cool. About how long did that fish cook for? Because it's fairly thick.
I cooked about 15 minutes.
Okay.
So this is the final product on the rice. It's a nice, like I said, a nice Easter color.
And the rice itself, can you get it any place? Or
usually specialty stores will have
items something
like this.
And is it cooked the same as just a regular white rice?
It's very simple. I like to cook, usually my rice with just salt and a little bit of water. Just
All right, okay.
The natural flavors come out.
Sure.
But similar as you would any other rice.
Exactly.
Great.
Okay, and I know we've had these, what you call them, was it fiddleheads before?
Fiddleheads, they're fronds.
I was calling them curlicues.
Curlicues, yeah. And this is something that comes out in the springtime at a lot
it
of
comes
places?
Out in the spring, yes. Like I said, a lot of vegetables are coming out in spring right now, so it's a fun time right now for chefs to play around and get ideas for the spring menu.
You're like a surgeon putting that together.
Right, yes.
Practice.
With the tweezers
Look
and everything.
The tweezers, you are.
The carrots.
You are good.
Did you just blanch those for
I did.
A short time? Or?
For a short time, you got to keep them al dente, so it gives a nice crisp flavor.
I like that crunch when you have vegetables, yeah.
When you have them in their mush, I'm not the biggest fan. I mean, I like it, but it's not the...
And there you go. Well,
and that's it. Good stuff.
Okay.
All right, so you said there's a new menu coming up for spring as well, and you're also, I would imagine, taking orders right now for Mother's Day. People are going to be looking for places to go. Dorrance is the place. Get on it now. Don't wait till like 3 days before and go, What am I going to do with Mom?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So we have a nice brunch menu put together. I'm already getting ideas, and like I said, spring vegetables are coming out, so it's going to be nice. Very nice. To
yeah.
Very
and
good.
You're also taking part in an evening uncorked.
Yes.
Which
next
is the second
Saturday.
Year in a row for the Dorrance.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us what dish you're providing.
I'm doing a duck gruyere.
Okay.
With bacon jam with a little bit of maple syrup. So
it's bacon jam.
Bacon jam.
You.
Maple
Rock
syrup.
And roll.
Yeah.
Sounds
duck.
Good to me.
You gotta keep it interesting.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So. And it's a great event. PBS
That's
has
good.
Such great programming on it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of local communities, you know, enjoy PBS, and people love PBS when they're sitting at home.
Yeah.
So
events like this, you feature what you can do at the restaurant.
And really brings community together, too.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's great.
And
right
you
out.
Even hold a lot of events over at the Dorrance, too. So if you're looking for a great location, head
That's
on over
spot.
There. If you're looking for a recipe, head on over to our website, roadshow.com.